your word today. Send your help our way in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You are the very present help in the time of trouble. Send help our way in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let your name be glorified in our lives in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. And so, according to the prophetic focus for the month, he said, the effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man avails much. Effectual or fervent means something burning. If you are trying to make a hole in the wood, if you are familiar with some of those craftsmen, if they want to make a hole in the wood, they put the drill. Thank God for that technology. But in the old time, they don't have drill that time. They had iron. If you put hot burning iron in any wood at any time, effortlessly you make a hole. Hallelujah. Yeah. And so when I said that the effect you are fervent, the word fervent is burning. So when your prayer life is burning, every hindrance in your way, we give up. Hallelujah. There is no material known to man, no matter how hard it is, that can resist fire, especially light. You know, there are different kinds of light. We have the kind of light that you can see, but there are some light that you cannot see. If it comes into your eyes, it will destroy the eye. The ultraviolet level. Hello? So there is no material that light cannot cut. Hallelujah. It will cut it. And so when your prayer life is burning, you will be operating at the frequency of ultraviolet. And at any time, it will slash any opposition. Hallelujah. And so what you need to do is to connect with that level. If you look at this front cell, for example, the kind of packaging, the thing that they put together that is generating this kind of light, it does not have the capacity to generate ultraviolet light. If you see X-ray machine is not like a phone. The thing inside, it has been built to release that kind of ray. And Bible said that the effectual, fervent prayer, the burning prayer, the effective prayer of a righteous man. A righteous man is a man that has been saved. A righteous man is a born-again child of God. He said the prayer or what is coming out of your mouth is fervent, is like that kind of ultraviolet rays that any material, he goes through it, it will cut it. Hallelujah. Like we said, no matter how hard that material is, light will still cut it. Brethren, you have been built by heaven to destroy or to level any mountain. That's why I started with that scripture, that a lion is the strongest of all the beasts. He turneth not away from any. You have inside you the machine that is able to produce ultraviolet rays. Hallelujah. Amen. Inside you is that ability. Jesus said, as the Father has sent me, so sent I you. The word that is coming out of your mouth is not just sound waves. It has the ability to cut through any mountain. God said, light be, and light was. And God said in Genesis chapter 1 verse 26, he said, God said, he created man in his own image. He said, man be in our own image. The same power, the same authority with which God said, light be, and light came into existence, it has been loaded in you. You don't need to be a professor of English language or linguistics to be able to understand that what the Bible said in Genesis 1:26 is what it meant. He said, man, be in our own image. But do you know, as strong as that lion is, the lion that has been raised in homes as pets for people, he has lost lion mentality. Hello? Even though he's a lion, he has everything inside him to devour any animal. But because he has been raised, his mentality has been changed. He's no more thinking as a lion, he's thinking as bingo, dog. And so he has lost the ability to devour the animal. And that's why they will say, I used to see that in South Africa. You see them playing with him, just using hand to rub head of a lion. Can you go to the bush and say, now I'm a professor of zoology. Lion, call, let me play with you. Very soon, you will end in the stomach. Hello? What makes a difference between a lion that is a pet or the one that is having the same of a lion is just his mindset. That's why the Bible says that it is unto man, what? The way you think. As a man thinketh, so is he. You have the ability to release the laser to cut that mountain. But if you are thinking as a goat, you will be running away from the mountain. That is why I want you to wake up right now. The Bible says that the effectual, fervent prayer of the righteous man avails much. Look at that scripture. James chapter 5, verse 13. Hallelujah. Amen. James 5, 13. He said, is any among you afflicted? What should he do? He should cry. Oh. He said, is any man, anyone among you afflicted, let him pray. He didn't let him complain. Complain will not change anything. In fact, it will complicate it. The more you complain, you know, it's like when we used to set a trap in Africa then. If the animal runs into that trap, the more he tries to struggle, the more the thing will tighten until it gets weak and die. So when you are complaining, what you are doing is that you are tightening the rope among you. You are supposed to react. He said, let him pray. Is anyone merry? Let him sing psalms. Is anyone sick among you? Let him call for the elders of the church. And let them pray over him, anointing him with oil in the name of the Lord. He said, and the prayer of faith shall save the sick. Said, and the Lord shall raise him up. Who will raise him up? Who will raise him up? Who will do the praying? Wake up. You have to do the praying before the Lord can raise up. Hello? Because God can't do anything until you speak it. You remember in Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, the Bible said, talking about the creation, it said, the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. The Spirit of God could not create anything until God said, light be. The Holy Ghost is waiting to manifest your prosperity. It's waiting to show up in your body and heal your children. But it's waiting for your word. It's waiting for your, what's your word? Your prayer. And of faith. Not prayer of fear. God, there's prayer of fear. Hey, it has happened. Oh my God. Don't pray, you're just complaining. But prayer of faith declares, it is well. That woman was told that her only son died. And said, okay, now let's carry the baby back to the prophet. And as she was running on the horse's back, the prophet said, what happened? He said, it is well. Was it not well? It's well. And so he said, pray. Pray. He said, and the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise him up. And if he have committed any sin, they shall be forgiven. Say, confess your fault one to another, and pray one for another, that he may be healed. Now, the effectual, fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth more. He said, now, let's look at verse 17. Hallelujah. He said, Elijah was a man subject to like passion as we are. It means Elijah was an ordinary man. Hallelujah. He was an ordinary man. Remember the other day we said that the Bible said that right from all the Old Testament, every prophet that you see, every pastor that you see, even Job, Abraham, all of them, Moses, that was so close to God to the extent that God was talking to him mouth to mouth. In terms of greatness, Jesus spoke. He said, none of them was as great as John the Baptist. And the same Jesus said, that same John the Baptist that you see is the, if you compare anyone in the kingdom of God, is still greater than him. Can God lie? Will God lie? So if God said you are greater than the greatest of the greatest in the Old Testament, he said, he meant what he said. For example, can you see a single example in the Old Testament where any man casted a demon from anywhere? We are casting a demon. Brethren, you are far greater than you think. Jehovah has noted in you more marvelous great virtue than you think. He said Elijah was a man subject to right passion as we are. And he prayed earnestly that it might not rain, and it rained not on the earth by the space of 3 years and 6 months. So he virtually locked the heaven. And his Bible said he wasn't as great as you. So that you are running away from that situation, what do you think heaven is saying? They're surprised. Hello?
Hi.
They're surprised. It's like a dog seeing a rat and saying, hey, I'm in trouble. What will the owner say? Ah, I will send this dog to the calamar. Because it's not my dog. Hello? It's not my dog. It has not done my mentality. Heaven said that you are greater far from her. And he said, Elijah locked the heaven. He said, no rain. If I be the man of God, let there be no rain in this nation. And heaven responded. And Bible says in verse 18, and he prayed again. And the heaven gave rain. And the earth brought forth. And so he has the ability to lock and to unlock. Hello? Ability to lock it. He was the one that locked it. And now there is to open it. Remember when he was praying to open it, did Jesus say, okay, Jesus, I was the one that locked it. The rain is not coming, no? Hello? You know, the people always do that. It's easier to spoil him than to create it, to repair. If you want to spoil a car, I just take wood, bam, on the windscreen, bam. But you go and see if you want to fix it, how long it's going to take. So he locked it, he said, if I'm a man of God, let there be no rain. God said, okay, no rain. When he said, okay, now, go and tell him there's going to be rain. He prayed, in Jesus' name, Jesus, let there be rain. Ah, no rain, no. Eh, what? He said, he prayed, he asked his servant, say, go and check. Is there any class there? Anything. Ah, no rain. He prayed and prayed again until rain came. You will see your result this year in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
This month, you will see the result of your prayer.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Matthew 18:18. Matthew chapter 18 and verse 18. Quickly, our time is past then. He said, verily I say unto you, whatsoever ye shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. Who said it? Who said it? The Most High said, you, my children, whatsoever. He didn't say whatsoever you may bind. He was saying with affirmation. He didn't say maybe it may happen sometimes. I'm thinking that is a chance, 50-50 chance or 70-30. No. He was saying 100% of the time, whatsoever ye shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever ye shall loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Again, I say unto you, that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done. Not it may be done. Not it can be done. It shall be done. The word shall in English means 100% assured that it will be done. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But, like we said, the Bible said, he called them God, but they will die like men because they have the mentality of men, not the mentality of God. Thank you, Jesus Christ. And so, prayer is so important. Prayer is so important. In fact, as a matter of fact, you can never be greater than your level of prayer life. That's the truth. Hello? It's not possible. It is absolutely not possible to be greater than the level of your prayer life. So if you want to go to the next level, what do? You fast in your bed. And say your aeroplane is flying and say, okay, they need to change altitude. Does he say, okay, you know, it's just it's one of those things we cruise and say, oh. Do you have to fire the engine? You want to move your car, there is this law called law of inertia, isn't it? That when object is in a state of rest, you need more force to push it to start moving than when it is moving to continue to move. And so, for your life to stop gathering dust, for your life to move to the next level, you need to push it. And how do you push it? On the altar of prayer. Like we said in that epistle that was read for us, there is no single revival anywhere in the world that was not born in the womb of prayer. So you better know now. And not run away from prayer. Hallelujah. The only way to guarantee your security against satanic assault is to be prayerful, sir. Hallelujah. We're going to be looking at that next week, but I want you to understand this one very well. This introduction today. To know that you are due for next level, but you need to fasten your belt. There is no greatness anywhere that is a product of wishes. Go and see all the stars in this world, in the world of sport. They spend extra time.
Yeah.
Go and look at the documentary of those people that they say the best player of the year, best basketball player of the year, best this, best is that. You think he's sitting at home and say, okay, give me SBC2, what is that, CNN3, or whatever. It's a lie. Hallelujah. No! It is always given back to in the womb of extra work. Look at Jesus' life. The Son of God, born by the Holy Ghost, had the anointing without measure, yet he prayed. Let's go to that Luke chapter 11. Hallelujah. How many minutes more do we have? Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Because you know, I remember when we were growing up, once they said this issue of prayer, we started saying, oh, it has come again. You better know it now. No alternative. Hello? It was saying, okay, that you know, beans and the money for it, no jar. Okay, I don't know how to put that one in English. But the truth is that you have to know now that the only way. Because until you do something, until somebody writes something, nothing can be written up. Thank you, Jesus. Luke 11. He said, and it came to pass in verse 1 that as he was praying in a certain place, who was praying?
Jesus.
Why did he have to pray? He had the anointing without measure. He was the Word. The Word that became flesh. So he knew the Word. Yet he prayed. Jesus prayed. In fact, at a point when he was about facing the challenge of the cross, he prayed until the capillaries of his head busted, and the Bible said his sweat was like blood. Have you prayed like that before? And you are saying you are speaking grammar. Hello? Let us fasten our belt, too. Hello? Let us fasten our belt because it is time. To pray, let's just read them. He said, The disciples said unto him, Lord, teach us to pray, as John also taught his disciples. Teach us to pray. So he didn't say, oh, no, but you know, prayer is one of those things that I do. I don't think you need to do it. Just take it easy. No. Instantly, he responded by saying, and said unto them, when ye pray, not if ye pray, not sometimes when you pray, but when you pray. Hallelujah. The Bible said, pray ye without what? Without ceasing. So always pray. That was me. Always pray. Always pray. Always pray. Thank you, Jesus Christ. You remember that after Jesus departed in Acts chapter 6, verse 2-4, Bible said, then the 12 called the multitudes in Acts 6, chapter 2, multitudes of the disciples unto them and said, it is not reason that we should leave the word of God and serve tables. Wherefore, brethren, look ye out among you, seven men of honest report, full of the Holy Ghost and wisdom, whom we may appoint over this business. Why? But, verse 4, we will give ourselves continually to what?
Prayer.
To what?
Prayer.
To what?
Prayer.
And to the ministry of the world. And so, this time, the church was growing. Boom, 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 boom. And they had administrative or logistic challenge. And the Bible said the apostles, they were wise. They discovered that now, if we continue to leave the ministry of prayer and be doing administrations, and every day you sit on the computer, you pray. You're not praying, you are doing things. You're not a man of faith. And you leave the ministry of prayer, before you know what's happening, flies will be eating on you. Because when the food is not hot, you put it down outside. Fly will say, especially during the summer, fly will say, ah, I see free food though. Let's go and eat. Hallelujah. But can you see flies? Say, okay, you have hot pizza. And then fly want to move around. It will become one of the meat. Hallelujah. And then you cut it and eat it together. Thank you, Jesus. What I'm about to say is that the ministry of prayer and the word are so important. The word will not work without prayer. Hello? Because the word has to be powered. It's not empty word. And prayer will not be effective without the word. He said, this is the confidence that we have. If we pray according to his will, what is his will? His will is his word. And so it's the combination of the ministry of the word and the prayer. When you stop praying, you start dying. That was after what killed the church. Every nation where the church stopped praying. I said we had a meeting at the time, and then the churches came together to meet with the highest body of church council in this nation. There was no single mention of prayer throughout the meeting. They were talking about the environment. We're not ministry of health, ministry of environment now. I said, yeah, no wonder. How will the testimony not be going down? Not a single mention of prayer throughout. It was all about you fighting for rights and then about the environment. Are we gardeners? We are planting flowers. And I said, no, I'm not going to be part of this meeting. I'm not cut for this. I want to go to a place where the next 2 hours you are blasting in the Holy Ghost. Lord, let there be revival in Sweden. Let every devil that is molesting families be humiliated. I told you the statistic last Sunday. 50-something thousand wedding, 20-something thousand divorce. That's for the devil. And this can be conquered on the altar of prayer. And say, Lord, you demon that is scattering family, we curse you in the name of Jesus Christ. Lastly, let's just read the scripture before we close today. Genesis chapter 1. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Genesis chapter 1. Let's start from verse 26. Hallelujah. Say, and God said, let us make man in our image and after our likeness, Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the fowl of the air and then over the cattle and over all the earth and over every creeping thing. So he created them. And then if you jump to verse 28, Bible said, and God blessed them. And like we said again and again, the word bless them means he empowered them. And he said, be fruitful, multiply, replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion. And then if you jump further down, Bible said, now, verse 29, you see that they have become living soul. Because if you read chapter 2 and verse 7, Bible said he put that spirit inside the man, and then he became a living soul. And now, the living soul could hear what God was saying. Verse 29 said, and God said, behold, so he said, look, I was speaking to the man now. He said, look, behold, I have given you every herb bearing seed, which is upon the face of the earth, and every tree in which is the fruit. Now, let's quickly run to verse 31. He said, and God saw everything that he made, and behold, it was good. So the creation was concluded. Now, in chapter 2, hallelujah, in verse 5, he said, thus the heaven and the earth were finished, and the host of them were finished. Now, in verse 2, he said, on the seventh day, God ended his work, which he had made, and he rested. Like we said, when you hear God rested, what comes to your mind? Villa Little, May, no? Hallelujah. He transferred the authority. What happened on the seventh day was the coronation. If you go to school to study law, and you finish in the law school, are you a lawyer yet? No. Until you are called to bar, the day you are called to bar is the day they hand over the baton to you to display, to operate as a lawyer. Hallelujah. You go to school to read accounting. Every nation have their own system. In Nigeria, for example, until you have until you become a chartered accountant. So the day they give that certificate to you as a chartered accountant, then you can operate in that office. As a medical doctor, you finish your house program. You know, after their training, they go for housemanship, isn't it? But there is something they call, I forgot the name right now, but they have to do that ceremony, induction. On the day when you do the induction, then you can say, now, you are a doctor, like when you can go and operate. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. And so God said to man, be in our own image, and then he empowered him. But until the day, on the seventh day, the day of coronation, when God said, now, I am taking, I'm bowing out, I'm relaxing, I'm resting from my assignment, because I have loaded you with the ability. And then that was the day he transferred everything to them. Did you get it now? You have a president. He won the election. Hallelujah. Can he go and say, okay, I'm the president right now? He's not yet the president. Hallelujah. The Lord bless you. He is not yet the president just because he won the election. The day they swear him in, and he said, I swear by Almighty that I'm going to defend the constitution of this country, and now you become the commander-in-chief of the army of the nation. That is the day, from that moment, that second, you can then operate as a president of that nation. The same way, God loaded man with the ability. But it was on the seventh day when God did the coronation, and then he said, now I can retire, be in charge. And so when you hear that God rested, it was not because he did hard work. He worked for 12 hours and said, now I need some Avedon. I need to take something to rest. Oh, yeah, what do we do? No. What he did was that he literally transferred the authority to the man. That's why the Bible said that the earth is the heaven, the earth. What, how did he put it now? Hallelujah. He said, the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. But the best man said that heaven is his throne, the earth he has given to the children of men. And so he has transferred the authority to you and I. So where then do we need to pray? Therefore, prayer is giving earthly license for heavenly intervention. So there is always need to pray, because heaven cannot intervene in the issue of the earth without being called. Do you understand it now? Prayer is so necessary because it will be illegal for them to come. Just like every sovereign nation, let's stand up. Thank you, Jesus. Every sovereign nation have their right to do their things their own way. Hello? Sweden can also okay, because I just love Gambia, or I just love Nigeria. I want to send the Swedish army very strong to go and do something that they will arrest them. Yeah. Neither will the police from Norway come into Sweden to come and arrest nobody. It doesn't have the right. Hallelujah. He doesn't have the rest. In countries like US, where they have state police, when you go and say, okay, I'm operating in Texas, and you take your uniform and go to Atlanta, they will arrest you. Hallelujah. They will arrest you. And so there is a rule to follow. Heaven said that you have to pray. Said then you will call on me, because it will be illegal for heaven to intervene. And so prayer is given legal standing for heaven to intervene in your situation. Hallelujah to Jesus Christ. Do you see now why it is important for you to pray? Your children have issue. Heaven wants to intervene. He said, call on me. Let me go and fight your battle with your children. And you say, no, I don't think I just have to do it. Heaven can do anything, because the scripture cannot be broken. Hallelujah. Somebody is trying to mess up your marriage, and heaven say, no, challenge him in the name of the Lord. And then you give the legal right for heaven to go and deal with him. Thank you, Jesus Christ. So prayer is giving legal backing to heaven to take over the battle on earth. You don't understand it now? And so when we say, okay, now let's pray. So don't see it as a body. Prayer is not for God. We can pray, like, will you ever pray that we help God? I say, oh God, in Jesus' name. And there's no more God. Hallelujah. Oh, God doesn't need prayer. Because it's already the Most High. There is no prayer that you can pray. Hello? Maybe I have to search up that one. Oh, Peter, in Jesus' name, this ministry is going down low. What do we do? He's always connected to heaven. Even when they came to arrest him, he said, oh, guys, if I want heaven, the angels to take over, I will have called them. Hallelujah. He told the disciples, pray. He told Peter, he said, the devil is about to want to shift you like wind. But I have prayed for thee that thy faith faileth not. If Jesus didn't pray for Peter, what would have happened? Maybe he would have killed himself too. Like Judas Iscariot. Hello? So let us pray, let us receive, let's begin to give God thanks right now. And say, Lord, thank you for opening my eyes to see this reality. Thank you for opening my eyes to see this reality. I give you thanks. I receive the grace to pray, to prevail on the altar of prayer. In the name of Jesus Christ, I receive the grace to prevail on the altar of prayer. In the name of Jesus, I receive the grace to prevail on the altar of prayer. In the name of Jesus, I receive the grace to prevail. In the name of Jesus Christ, I receive the grace to prevail. In the name of Jesus, I receive the grace to prevail on the altar of prayer. In the name of Jesus Christ, I receive the grace to prevail. In the name of Jesus Christ, my prayer life shall not go down. In the name of Jesus, my prayer life shall not go down. In the name of Jesus, thank you, Jesus. Blessed be your name, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
You get it now. And so I want you to leave this place with that mentality, a new way of thinking about prayer now.
that if I'm not praying, heaven can't act. Hello? It will be illegal. And God will not sin. It will be illegal. You have to pray. As a man, you have to pray for your family. You stand in God. Do you know that Adam, he did not take charge of the garden? That was why the serpent entered. He was given the responsibility of watching over the garden, but he opened it up. Many men, they are complaining about their wives. They're not praying for them. Hello? Many women say, oh, my husband did that. When last did you sit down on your knee and say, until there is a trick, like Jacob, I won't let go. What would have happened if Jacob didn't pray that day? And when I say, well, after all, I'm the son of Abraham. Abraham had money. If I'm not working hard, I will go back and claim my Abraham's property. No! He said, I won't let you go. What did you think he was doing? He was angry. No, he was praying. He said, no! As a seed of Abraham, this cannot continue in my life. Something must happen. What would have happened if Jabez didn't pray? It would have become a concern, died as a concern. What would have happened if Hannah didn't pray? Hannah had the right to the blessing of Abraham, of fruitfulness. But Hannah said, no, you won't go. And she said, no, no. Jesus, show up. You spoke your word according to Genesis chapter 1 in verse 28. Be fruitful. Whatsoever is hindering my fruitfulness, you must give way. Ah! And God said to the prophet, hallelujah. Do you want to pray again before we take the communion? That Lord, every mountain in my life must be leveled. They must not pass this month. Hallelujah. Remember, this is a month of resurrection. Lord Jesus, show up in my family. Lord Jesus, show up in my business. Lord Jesus, show up in the life of my children. Lord Jesus, show up in my body. I cannot continue to serve this sickness. My children cannot continue to serve this sickness. I cannot continue to be a concern when it comes to finances. I cannot continue to be a concern at my working place. You said, I am the head and not the tail. I am the light of this world. I am the salt of this world. Show up in my life, Jesus. Show up in my life, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. The Bible said Jesus.